English as second language and English as foreign language. We will discuss that and also linguistic imperialism and language rights. We have just discussed the three circles of or model of Kuchrue. He has given the inner circle, which comprises of basically the first language and the countries where the English is used as first language. Then the outer circle, which involves English as second language and the acquisition of that in terms of language which is used in multilingual environment. And then the expanding, the third circle, which is the expanding circle, which where you have English as foreign language. The aspect or the purpose is to see how that language is accepted and recognized globally and how that language has been expanded globally to carry out certain functions in terms of getting orientation, getting familiarization with what is happening in the world or what is happening globally. So now talking about where these different types are taught and how it affects or what are the factors which actually lead to linguistic imperialism. English as second language is taught to students in a country where English is the primary language, it's the dominant language. English as foreign language is taught to students in country where English is not the native language. So it is used for functional purposes, as those functions which have to be carried out globally. Now, linguistic imperialism, in the light of that, we have to understand has been defined as the transfer of dominant language to other language, dominant language to other language. It has also been defined as the imposition of a language on people who belong to different or who speak different languages. Some of the synonyms the linguistic imperialism has is the linguistic dominance, or you say language nationalism, linguistic language dominance as well, linguistic imperialism, linguistic dominance, and so on. Now, looking at this context, the one that we have at the moment, some feel that English is also considered in the form of imperialism. Reason is the expansion that it has, or the global expansion and the global need. It is sort of, it has become important for people not belonging to the culture of English to speak and to interact in order to remain up to date or have interaction with people overseas, or you can say people from different parts of the world. Linguistic imperialism and language rights. Now, a central issue in the linguistic imperialism debate is devaluing of native languages through the clonal spread of English. So, devaluing of native languages have been seen in the form of colonial spread of English. The other is, as teachers of English, some of our primary goals should be the highest respect for language. So if we are dealing with the language rights, we have to understand that the respect is very important for the languages and cultures of our students, whether they belong to a culture which is less dominant as compared to the dominant culture, or the language that they are using from that dominant culture, and also the preservation of diversity among human beings. So understanding and respecting the fact that human beings come from diverse background, and therefore their views and their languages and their cultures should be respected. Second language curricula must not impose a foreign value system on learners. This is very important. We must be aware that English as an international language is a two-edged sword that carries with its danger of imperialistic destruction of our global ecology and also cultures. So language rights demand or respect the respect as well as the recognition of these languages. To conclude, second language learning in a culture foreign to one's own potentially involves the deepest form of culture acquisition, for the transfer of dominant languages to other people occur because of linguistic imperialism.